Hi, this is Pranav Guha Thakurta from Edu TV. In my favorite program, it's a matter of principles. Today we have Mr. Sayyed Shaukat Ali, Principal, Ideal Indian School, Doha, Qatar. Welcome, sir.
Welcome. Thank you so much.
And we have Madam Sheila Mahapatra, she's the head of Electrical Department of Alliance University, Bangalore. Sir, she will be your host.
Yeah.
Great. Over to you, ma'am.
I am also Bangalorean.
Okay.
I am from Bangalore.
Oh, you're from Bangalore. Wonderful.
Yeah.
So then whenever now next time you're in Bangalore, there's a standing invitation for lunch or dinner at Alliance University. Fine, sir.
Fine, sir. No issues. I am from Bangalore. I am staying in Sakarnagar in Bangalore.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Over to you, ma'am.
Good morning, sir. This is Dr. Peter from Alliance University, Bangalore.
Yeah.
And it's a pleasure to have you here today. To begin with, sir, as we all are aware that, you know, the COVID-19 pandemic has been a most challenging situation for almost all the government across the globe and for people alike. And just like, you know, every cloud has a silver lining. So to bring some positivity to it, there has been a lot of innovative methods. There has been thinking out of the box solutions being available to fight this unprecedented situation. I believe one of the sector which has been deeply affected by this pandemic has been the educational sector, irrespective of whether it is schools or colleges, because you know, there has been a total paradigm shift in the way in which we deliver our lectures. So although with technology and the online platform being available, teaching learning process has definitely continued unabated, and that itself is a sense of positivity. With that respect, what I would like to know from you today is how do you at your school maintain the morale of your employees high? And when I say employee, I mean the teaching staff to a greater extent, because for them it is extremely challenging and a total different situation with respect to the teaching deliverables, which has shifted from the physical classrooms to the online sessions. If you can throw some light into this.
First of all, thank you for Edu TV as well as you, ma'am. And in addition, I thank Alliance University, Bangalore. Since I am from Bangalore, it is privileged, and I'm really glad to join with you people today. Quite obvious, there is this question arising in total society, and every parent, every stakeholder, and every individual is asking the same question what you asked me today. Indeed, COVID has taught us a wonderful lesson. The lesson is,
correct,
why should teaching learning happen only in physical presence of children? Why it can't happen in the online platform? This is the greater lesson, and this is a paradigm shift, as you told. This is a new innovation in education. This is an innovation in education and education philosophy. Quite interesting it is for the teachers to learn new platform like online teaching. Initially, we too had some issues pertaining to online teaching as well as connectivity, etc. But this has become new normal of life now.
Correct.
And future also, education will be like this.
True, very true.
Children started rather loving online teaching more than physical teaching now. Frankly speaking, now we started physical schooling from past 1 month, 1.5 month, around 42% of children are coming per day.
Okay.
So I have approximately, earlier I had 6,300 students. Now I have around 5,000 children in the school because of government restriction here. So when students are coming, they are very happy with the online teaching. But initially, there was certain issues pertaining to connectivity, then pertaining to the Zoom piracy problems, as well as the data breach, etc., etc. Teachers also were very much tense because of other people involving in the class and writing vulgar words, etc., etc., in the chat box. This was the quite challenging issues we faced here in Qatar. Those have been resolved now, and we have got acquitted as well as adjusted with the current scenario. However, we give a lot of training to the teachers, and we had different platforms used at the time. Initially, we started with Zoom, as well as we started with BlueJeans. We purchased BlueJeans as one of the software, and we started doing. Now, later, we happened to spend a lot of money on this for the sake of getting the school management software, like different softwares for having online teaching. But having said that, let me tell you that there is nothing like physical teaching. There is no replacement for actual teacher. Nobody can replace actual teacher. To be frank with you, if I want to tell you in one line, every teacher wants Arjuna in the class, who is smart enough in every field.
Yes.
But you cannot find always Arjuna in every class. There will be some people who are below average. For those kind of students, it is really tough to understand all. Especially subjects like mathematics, especially subjects like accountancy. This is really challenging for the children to understand. Online, this is a bigger challenge to explain these two subjects, especially mathematics as well as accountancy. For not brilliant children, for the below average children. And we started with differentiated learning. We started with one-to-one teaching to the students. Now we are having blended learning, which we are going ahead and doing in the school. But of course, there is impact on teaching learning system, a lot of impact on teaching learning system. Children have not developed the confidence of writing examinations. And there is a tendency, younger minds. Now, for example, if I am talking with you now here, I can open one more window on my system and see some game. So this tendency is there in online system. If that is resolved, online is also a best education.
Yep.
But provided the children should give 100% concentration for the classes. That is.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So moving from faculty or your teaching staff to the students, so as you just now told us that you have already commenced with the blended mode, which gradually in India also we are starting. But the next challenging task, as you just said, is to make the student understand the situation and to make them fall into the line. So if you look at it from a student's perspective, it's like, for them, they are confined to home. They're in fact seeing the faces of their parents only. They are missing out their, getting mingling with their peer group and all the activities which they might be doing while at school. So with that respect, if I ask you how in your school you have been able to generate the kind of excitement and a sense of positivity for the students to fight against this COVID-19 situation or this pandemic situation at this time.
Wonderful question. Thanks for that wonderful question.
Yeah.
This is a unique situation. Very unique situation. All of us are facing, including you, me, all of us. To generate positivity in the students, we ourselves created certain play areas or play things for the students. We are doing virtual tours where students are taken to museums and all. And one information, let me tell you, Qatar government is very supportive. And they have taken amazing steps to see that the number of corona cases reduces.
That is indeed very good.
And the drastic steps they have taken. Trust me, madam, every individual is treated free of cost.
Wow.
Total treatment is free of cost, even including COVID testing. And all teachers, before school started, we started with COVID testing, including principal. I got COVID test done, and we started this blended learning.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is a mandatory reform. There are strict rules and regulations initiated by the government, which we are strictly following. And they are following it up regularly with the schools. And in case if some parents are getting infected with this virus, they're immediately informing schools via phone, via emails. They are getting information from the school. And we have created in every building. I got 5 buildings in the school. In each floor, in each building, we have created one room as isolated.
Oh, okay.
So isolated room in each building we have created. So that is requirement. And we have our own clinic here in the school. So our all nurses are equipped with this. Now, your question was about how children are getting motivated. First, I'm answering that question in the right way. First and foremost thing here, children are going with the parents outside malls, various parks, because government has given an app called the Aetherus app. And if the app is green, you can go anywhere. There is no lockdown here. They have not created any lockdown. First point. I'm answering this question with that. Then second one, children are confined to house. No doubt about it, but are confined even to other places also. They have gone to other places and they are enjoying. Only if initial few days, around 4 to 5 days, they had some strict rules and regulation for lockdown kind of things. Afterwards, it was open. Then, secondly, we as a school, we started giving motivation talks to the children. I arranged a few webinars for motivational speakers. And even we are not teaching children, we are teaching parents. Literally, we are teaching parents.
That's a very good initiative.
Yeah, actually, what we are doing, we are teaching parents how to handle children at home. How to make it, because actually, psychologically, children are just demotivated nowadays. And if you read the mind of children, what is happening, where we are, whether we are in the current world or our world is like this. So they started thinking in these angles, especially younger children. So we started motivating them about coronavirus, and we started giving information about how this virus spread, etc. And above all this, we are doing certain yoga sessions, physical education sessions in the school, where teachers are doing in front of children. And believe me, even parents were doing yoga along with us. Okay, so that was the scenario, and we created that kind of environment where even parents were happy to learn certain yoga, this one, and certain exercises. And we have done some virtual tours. In addition to that, in the school, initially, when in September the school started, in September they told us to call only 30% of students. Then later they shifted in November, they told you start with the 42% of students.
Okay.
So we started like this. So September, when 30% of students came, we have maintained everywhere, because the entire campus is sanitized every day, and we are doing, see, everywhere you see sanitizers, and we have invested a lot on the mask. Everything is available in the school, where any child is not coming with mask, we are giving. But what we did before that, we educated parents how to allow the child to wear mask, how the child should use mask. And we educated parents in such a way that the KG student and first standard student need not wear mask according to government rule here. KG children, we are not allowing them to wear mask. They can come freely. But in each classroom, we are maintaining 2 feet, more than 2 feet distance. Okay. And teacher is not going near the student.
Right. So, if you look at, just if we go back to history and, the other pandemics, like let us say about the Spanish flu, or if you look at the plagues pandemic. So, the positive side, if you have seen or if we have observed, there has indeed been an industrial revolution after every pandemic. And even in the recent situation of this COVID-19 pandemic, it is a complete digital revolution. The world has in fact moved forward by almost 5 years in terms of digitalization. So with that aspect, what are the some activities or something what the school has been taking as an initiative on the virtual platform during this pandemic period? If you can just throw some light into that.
Actually, as you told, we have moved ahead 5 years, but I will tell you, we have moved ahead 10 years, more than 5 years, more than 10 years we have moved ahead. we never intercepted, we never thought that one day we will come where we have to go online and teach.
Right.
Being myself teacher, biology teacher, so we never thought that we will go and teach students in front of cameras. First point. Second point is we are doing various technology use like flip classrooms very easy. And if you go to our website www.idealschoolqatar.com, you will see some videos where we have used augmented reality to teach students, augmented reality and various things. And even we are using various tools which are currently available in the market. Digitally, Qatar is far ahead in place of internet providing as well as all various technology use. However, India is great, no doubt about it. India is having better infrastructure because our population is quite high. But here, the technology is also good and internet and all is cheaply available, to be frank. But for the schools and all, we have that lease line kind of thing. So we have taken lease line, which is particularly coming to school as a lease line, where you can have better connectivity. Okay, so from the school, we have got in the school, in all the classroom, LED panel board, which is 65-inch LED panel board, which can be like a smartphone. So it is like a smartphone, almost smartphone. So teachers are using to make teacher learning better. And this digital era has given one thing in the brain of every individual and every teacher and every management, that forget about investing on infrastructure of building. Now try to invest on the infrastructure of technology.
Right.
Every management started thinking about invest on the technology rather than investing on the buildings. Because your classroom will not remain the same classroom in future. I'm telling you now itself, in future, you will get 100 students. Out of 100 students, you have to give them option. Are you willing to go for virtual classes or are you going for physical classes? Both options you have to give to the children, where children can go for blended learning. Blended learning will become quite normal in future.
Considering places where there is extreme traffic chaos, sitting at home and attending a class is a blessing.
Yes, it is really a great blessing. And they see, for example, there are few children who are wasting a lot of time in traveling. So I have 105 buses, big buses and all, 105. So every day, early morning, 5:30, because the school starts here by 6:45, early morning. The student has to leave by 5 o'clock, early morning. So this traveling is reduced.
Correct.
Traveling is reduced. As children coming by buses. And many children are opting. And government has given liberty here is, if any parent is having any chronic disease like diabetes, children are exempted to attend physical class. Children are exempted from attending physical class. For example, any parent is hypertension, or any parent is having diabetes, or any parent is having some like other chronic diseases. So they will get one medical certificate stating that these children should be exempted from the physical class. They can come online. So we are doing both the side. And we are given option. This choice we have left to parents and students. And it's purely left to the parents to decide whether they have to send children for the class online or offline. Both, we are given that. Yeah. And secondly, the basic thing is, this is the best revolution happened. And Corona is not a big disease, to be frank. The death rate is quite low here. Our Qatar has maintained very highly death rate. There is no death rate more here. But moreover, some people got serious diseases, serious problems, only those who have got other chronic diseases. Other than this, Corona has taught us very good thing that teaching can be beyond the classroom. The teaching has gone beyond the classroom, and we are going to follow now the Rishi Muni kind of teaching system, what you could call it as Gurukul system.
Right.
And Indian traditional teaching is happening now in the current scenario. And moreover, individual concentration, differentiated learning, and student-centric learning is happening, not teacher-centric. Teacher-centric learning is happening.
Sir, it was a wonderful session with you today. And, on that positive note, always believing that the glass is always half full and not half empty, and deriving all the positivity out of this difficult and unprecedented situation. It was wonderful hearing you out. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you, EDTV. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Principal.
Good luck to Alliance University.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, this is Syed Shaukat Ali from Doha, Qatar, principal of Ideal Indian School, one of the oldest premier institution in Qatar, which is working from past 36 years in Qatar. I wish good luck and keep watching EDTV always.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Alliance University, India's top-ranked university. Over 20,000 alumni in 50 countries. Study abroad options in 55 universities and placements in over 353 companies. Alliance University, Bengaluru.